People, the moski is here at RogueDraw. The challenge for the moski has to draw a character in 30 minutes or less. Let's generate the character, shall we? Today is going to be a male, human, short, lawyer, delicious. A lawyer, delicious is appearing a lot lately. But well, I'm not going to tell the generator how to do his job. We get this. We already had the delicious scientist and the delicious archer. It was an archer, right? Well, let's then just make this delicious again. It's part of the fun. Let's see what changed from character to character. Let's go. Okay. A delicious human. He's short. He's a lawyer. Well, he's not delicious. Or maybe is he? But would he still be a human? Maybe so. Maybe it's a lawyer that specializes in taking cases where the kids decide to demand to send a lawsuit to their dentist because they did a very bad job. Okay, that could work. Let me just check the distance of this thing. Actually, let's keep it. Let's try to make the character without zooming in. I'm not going to zoom in on for this one in order to try to keep an idea of how the guy goes. Yes. I think in my experience, which is not much because I think this we just hit double digits not long ago on this series, is in my experience the sketching has taken probably a lot of time because I do a lot of strokes without having a clear idea. This guy is going to be like rustling papers over here instead, like saying that hey, that what you're saying is incorrect. The papers over here are actually saying that, hey, you're wrong and you shouldn't be able to send lawsuits to our dentist officers over here because you are incorrect. Something like that, I don't know, like say that, hey, I got the papers. I got information that says that you're probably just rigging the things in order to get money from the people that you had to pay a lot to get your freaking teeth corrected. But well, he's short. He's like probably going to give him a curly mustache just to make sure that he's short but he's not a kid. I should really get used to doing this without zooming in, but well, what can we do about that? Not much, I think. Hey, I don't really know how this is going to look delicious other than conceptually. I don't like it that when I draw the characters and it doesn't really resemble the thing. Maybe he's actually trying to protect the... that's how it's going to be. This guy is a corrupt lawyer. He's getting bribes or... well, not bribes. He's getting paid to defend the people who make the candies, even though he knows that they actually do bad to the kids, to the children. So he's probably got his pockets, let's make a pocket here, full of lollipops. And then he's got like a tie. He's going to be like the Willy Wonka's lawyer. I actually can live with that. Let's say that this is Willy Wonka's lawyer. I never watched the movie from Willy Wonka. What was the name of the movie? Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory or something like that? Yes, he's going to be Willy Wonka's lawyer. But well, I want to watch it, if only for the creep factor. Because well, you know how there's the condescending Wonka meme, and I am really into memes every now and then. He's going to have some sort of chocolate bar over here. Yes, just like this. The hat is made of chocolate too. So he's going to be like the candy lawyer. And his mustache, this gorgeous mustacho, is going to be made of peppermint. So he's not exactly... he wasn't bribed. He's getting paid to defend all of the children that get traumatized by Willy Wonka's factory. I remember people saying that on that film there were like cutscenes or scenes cut from the movie where teachers were taking... are transformed into candy and the like. I don't even know if people were eating them. Well, anyhow, we got our short candy lawyer who's going to defend Willy Wonka until the end of times. He's like his best friend. And now I'm drawing fan fiction from something that I haven't even watched. So there, freaking, wait, I said that wouldn't zoom in, but well, this is mostly done anyways. The sketches, at the very least. Well, we got this, and now I can wait. Just making sure that it looks right either way, because you know I have this little condition on my eyes, which means that I shouldn't be an artist by any sort of indication. But that's not stopping me from drawing. Like I said before, just follow your dreams, man. Just follow your dreams. Man, woman, children, whatever, whoever you are, this does not apply to just one specific kind of people. So, we're going to go with 10. And now that I got a sketch that I'm mostly proud of, I can zoom as much as I want. Yeah, did I think I actually, yes, I clicked on the timer, right? It's running. I just want to check if it's running. I always forget. It's running. It's not on 30. I didn't even notice exactly how much time has already gone, but I think this is I'm in a very comfortable position. How much has it been? 5 minutes? 4 minutes? 3 minutes? Not 1 minute, definitely. But I think it was not that much. So now, the idea here with not zooming in when doing this sketch is because I've noticed that some of my drawings lately have been very, very simplistic. Instead of trying to go with features and the like, and I'm like, when I draw the archer, I said, hey, the archer looks nice. Why does he not, how did I get some enough time to make him look this nice? And then I remembered, hey, he has no face. Of course it's going to look nice. Well, not that it's going to look nice, not that I draw horrible faces. I might do, but my point is that I didn't spend too much time drawing the face because I just obscured it on the first opportunity that I had. So yes, I want to these drawings to have a bit more of detail, but to give them detail, I need to give up on something else. That's the problem with limited time, or actually just capitalism and limited resources overall. You have to prioritize on something, and if you want something else, you have to give up on something else. So we got this. Actually, at this point, with this many delicious characters, I'm going to have like a whole candy multiverse or the like. We already got the scientist that is probably working for Willy Wonka too. I actually like this idea. We got the archer that is trying to help the people that were annoyed by Willy Wonka and that got their teeth rotten. And then we got the scientist that is making everything all of that happen. And then we got this lawyer that's trying to defend them. Maybe this lawyer is going to give a lawsuit to the apple guy, or maybe those are candy apples. They could be candy apples. We got all of the crew of wow, mind blown. What if every character in this generator is actually related to Willy Wonka? Pom pom pom. We got the fire. What was it? A hippie? How do you? That's going to be another fun exercise. Try to relate every moski character to Willy Wonka. The fire elemental, he was once a fan of Willy Wonka products and then died in a fire in one of the factories, and now he then decided to, how do you call it, haunt all of the Willy Wonka's workplaces. But then one day he found weed and thought, hey, yo, this is relaxing. And then he stopped hunting people because he was very, very chill about that. Who knows? Maybe that works. Actually, let's just make it official as well. It's going to have this WW, which means Willy Wonka, blah, 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 and blah. Yeah, the details can come in later. Then let's work on the eyes. Let's try to make something that is not beady eyes again, because I'm getting tired of those. Actually, let's just try to make him like a bit of more detail than the usual, just to make sure that this guy is not just a child. He's not a child, he's just has a small body. There's a lot of people like that. I have met some people with where they are very small of stature, and well, they're usually very chill people about that. There's not much building over here. Well, it's Mexico, there are places, but as I've told you, I grew up in a place with a private education, and there's actually a very big difference. And I really don't like how you can change a life dramatically because of the money that you have available for yourself. That's just unfair, but well, that's life, sadly. Anyhow, Willy Wonka and all of his friends. This is going to be like my own very own fan fiction series about how Moski is drawing Willy Wonka characters. At the end, at the end of this episode, trust me, I'm going to go into the editor and add a bunch more of words, because it's uncanny that this early on I already have the same word repeated 3 times. It's just not saying that it's not fair. I'm saying that, well, it's fun. One way, this is going to be cut on handy hair, by the way. I'm saying that I like how the characters can look very different one from another when you just change some another word and add another word to the feature. For example, if this had been like in the first episode that we had an accountant, he would probably look like the first guy that I drew, but instead of being average, he was more like full of mints and chocolate and pudding, and was going to work with Willy Wonka to make sure that his numbers were right, that all of the production was in order, and that the people who were being turned into candy were all accounted for. Kind of something like that. Who knows? But maybe we're going to find out someday if this theme of drawing delicious characters keep going. Maybe if I drew if I draw enough delicious candy-related characters, maybe I can get some job at the people with the people that make Adventure Time and tell them, "Hey, you got the Candy Kingdom. I got candy randomly generated characters. Maybe we can work together." That's just a very wild dream. It's not like not even my dream. I don't want to work with them. Not saying that, well, I wouldn't take the opportunity if they paid correctly or handsomely, but it's not like a long time dream. My dream, I don't even really know if I have an actual dream, but it's something along the lines of moving out to probably Canada or the USA, or no, not the USA, maybe, who knows, but mostly Europe or anywhere where the heat is not this horrible. I don't want to live for the rest of my life in a place where 35 Celsius is the law, but I also want a place without no crime. I have already said that many, many times. So yes, I want to move out. I want to get some white collar or blue collar job, pay just enough to keep financing my gaming habits and maybe drawing habits. Maybe actually make a living of drawing. That would be the best. That would be badass. But at this point, it's not likely until I get enough time to practice. And to get enough time to practice, I have to have a lot of money. But no, the money is irrelevant. If you're in high school, middle school, if you're watching this and you still study on the obligatory or the free education, I'm going to tell you that you have the time. You just have to know how to manage it. You're never going to have this perfect opportunity to draw, to make your videos, to live your dreams, because everything just keeps changing, and you probably are better off just starting, forgetting everything and just starting. This is a tip that I actually got from a friend of mine, Jars. He also makes his own videos. He told me that, hey, if you want to start doing YouTube, just go for it. You're never going to have a good chance. And he was so freaking right. There's never a good time to start something. You just have to do it. Otherwise, if you're, for example, I've been sick when I was sick when I began making these videos. What happened? I got sick, then friends came over, and then it was one thing after another. So, well, if I were to stop and wait for the perfect opportunity, then I would probably not have started making these videos yet. I really appreciate that this is like the 12th, the 13th episode, or something like that. And I like it. I like how this is going. He's going to have like blue cotton candy hair, not pink. Blue. It's irrelevant. Actually, he can have both if he wants to, right? He worked for Willy Wonka. The guy is as fabulous as they get. Let's just put it on another layer. Actually, his mustache is going to be pink too? No, I said he was going to have a peppermint mustache. A peppermint mustache is going to be like red, and then some sort of white stripes. I like it. I think the mustache, the bow is also going to be peppermint. Let me just color this. He's going to have this pink outline, actually. But it's more like purple or a very thick, not thick, a very soft. I don't know what color this is, but it's something like a very dark pink. It works just fine. Let's just keep making a layer for everything, just to make sure that it's all working alright. Now, what is going to be the color of his suit? It's going to be probably white, but you know how this goes. I'm going to go use a color that is probably not going to be in the main character. Tools, limit to current layer. Maybe I don't even really know if you watch this for the entertainment or to try to learn something. You let me know in the comments if you would like me to tell you all of my actions in order to give you ideas of more or less what you can do if you want to draw characters. For example, as I was saying, I was filling this, and then just follow me for a minute. I'm going to select brown and then color everything over here. Then I'm going to change layer and make a new one in order to color the top hat in a different shade of brown. And now that it's been colored, I'm going to make another layer below that one and make the little thing over here white. He's going to have his suit on the same color of the hat. I'm saying it out loud, like giving subtitles to my life, if only to help you understand what's going on, what I'm doing with the drawing. And maybe if you're new to coloring or to making line art, you're going to be saying like, hey, that helps a lot, because otherwise you go too fast on your videos. I want to know how you do the things that you do. And first, thank you very much. That gives me a lot of confidence. And second, well, then now you can know it. And knowing is half the power. No, that was half the battle. Freaking, I have never watched G.I. Joe either, but that's how my friends say it, that whenever we learn something, we say like, well, knowing is half the battle. G.I. Joe. Let me take a sip of water. Freaking G.I. Joe killed my throat. I'm going to give them a lawsuit. And then who's going to laugh? Probably them at me, because, well, I don't even know if the people that made the G.I. Joe cartoon or scripted or directed it or whatever are still alive. I really want to believe that they are, in the 50s, 60s. I don't know how old that cartoon is, but, well, you get the idea. Wait, now he has we're going to color him quickly. Actually, I'm going to make a new layer with white above this one, so this doesn't really matter. What else? I think everything is alright. Okay, new layer. This one is going to stay above the previous one. Then we're going to color the eyes. Actually, let's just delete this little excess over here, over there. We got it. See, I don't use only the fill tool to make these sort of things. Actually, the gloves are also going to be white. Wait, I'm not erasing. I'm erasing. I shouldn't be erasing. There we go. And the teeth, of course. Actually, they should be yellowish because of all of the excess of candy. That would be creepy, but, well, that's also something that is natural in life. Not everyone has perfect teeth. I don't like how everyone, even in zombie apocalypses or the like, have perfect nail polish and perfect teeth. Actually, this layer isn't necessary. No, it's not unnecessary, but I'm not going to work on it right now, because I want this to also have a peppermint pattern. Then white. And then the candies. This one is going to be like a pink lollipop. Lollipop, lollipop, dum dum, the lollipop. And then the star is going to be yellow. Wait, excuse me. Excuse me, what is going on? Going nuts. Okay. And now, actually, let's make this white too. Keep everything in one concealed layer. The layer for the lawyer. And then the papers. I got the papers. They're going to be, well, they should be white too. But he's Willy Wonka. He probably has the most flamboyant papers in the world. So they're going to be like bluish for some reason. Well, one blue and one purple. There we go. Not that purple, actually a bit lighter. Like this one. Yes. So he's like, hey, on this candy scripts, we've got wording that the guy wanted to be transformed into a candy and be digested by small children. That's a bit creepy. This is getting out of hand. Well, we're going to give this guy blue eyes. This, actually? Yes, yes, this works. More or less, this is fine. This is just amazing. I'm actually very happy with how this one is turning out. Wait, wait, this, wait for it. We still need to color this like this. There we go. Actually, let's just play a bit with the shade of this thing, with the hue. Like this one, no? This one? This brown is okay, let's increase the value and see what happens. Lighter brown, it should be darker. Just fine, just fine. Then we're going to play with the hair. We're going to increase the value as well. Where is the value, value, value? Is it fine? Or the saturation maybe? Nah, it's a it's fine, it's fine. Okay, not... I'm not going to waste most of my time there because I already have to start the shading. Otherwise, I'm going to be again behind schedule. Schedule, schedule. Okay, we got this, we got this. Everything is colored. What is over here? Oh, the hat. I did. That's still white. Never mind. We're going to group everything up. Then going to right click on our group, select the opaque. Use my shortcut to increase the growth by 10. It's over there. And now below everything, as usual, make a new layer. Use the color of the outline to give it an extra cartoonish outside while also filling some of the gaps. Some should probably still be filled with manually to make it look better, but let's just see how this goes. Then we're going to ignore the outline. We're going to select only the fills, group them again, and then select the opacity again. Select opaque. And now we're going to create our new layer and try to do the shading. Not try to, I want to believe that it's going to happen. Because I'm doing it right now. Overlay. That doesn't work on whites, right, I forgot. So we're going to do something different for them later. But then we're going to reduce it. Actually, let's just... I just deleted the white, the thing that I drew over here. Because otherwise it's just going to be... I don't know, maybe if I decide to change the... overlay setting is just going to mess everything up if I keep a colored part that shouldn't be colored. Just reduce the distance of our stabilizer over here. Then the teeth are going to... they're barely visible. Maybe if I increase the opacity of this thing. Oh boy, I don't like how it looks over there. The problem here is that the overlay works with the values of the colors, and sometimes there's some color theory that I can't really explain with the correct terminology, but you have to learn a bit of that too if you want to get into coloring using the overlay tool, because it can make bright things brighter and dark things darker. But also, if you're going to try to do overlays over very intense colors like pure white and pure black, you're not going to get anything. I mean, the more neutral the color is, like for example, this one is too light, so the shading, the overlay doesn't look so powerful. This one is more neutral, it's more like on this area. If it's over here or it's over there, the impact is going to be less visible. And by the way, if you download a Krita and decided to play on your own with the settings, you're probably going to have a completely different thing over here. This is something that I like changing on my own because I think it makes the pictures brighter. Well, at least for me, because I used it to make a lot of drawings and all of them were very... not dark, but they were not vivid enough for my liking. Actually, the whites are going to be... how do you call it? Shaded manually. This is going to be on a single... this is all a single layer with one single color in order to save time. Like in the first episodes, I wanted to color, to shade everything on its own. But then I got overwhelmed by the second, by the episode of the elephant, it was already a small disaster. Actually, the mustache is going to be a problem too, so I'm going to color it or shade it later. Yes. My point is, that's going to be my catchphrase now. My point is, I say that so much. Better, my point is that, exactly. I was not saying that on... that one! That one I did say unintentionally, but you know how this goes. There are many people that start and have these mental mulets. We call them mulets in Spanish. I don't know how do you call them in English, where we just keep dabbling with certain words. And now silence, because I'd rather not say anything than try to go back to those times, to that very bad habit. Not bad, but well, it just shows lack of confidence. And when I'm drawing here, trying to not to say that I have a lot of confidence in what I'm doing when I'm supposed to be doing improv, and I'm doing improv here. None of this is scripted, you know. Well, it is programmed, not script. In like the generator has its certain values, but it's not like I go into the episode. I know that what the generator is going to pop up. I'm saying that I have 5 minutes left. Okay, that's worked fine. That's worked just fine. The coloring is mostly accounted for, at the very least the most basic ones. So I'm going to try to speed things up just a bit. Still no moment. Wait. Still no real reason to panic. Stay calm, do not panic. It's only because they haven't hatched yet. I have watched that specific Archer episode so many times. The one, what was, I think the name was called Vision Quest. If you watch Archer and you haven't watched that one, I really recommend it. It's probably my favorite on the series despite how simplistic it is. I think that's actually the reason I like it so much. Because, well, it's one small concept that just goes on and on and on, but it's always interesting to see the interaction between the characters and the like. And now, what else is missing on this drawing? Other than time to further increase it, and it's probably more backstory about how Willy Wonka met this guy and they became the best friends ever, and then probably some yaoi involved, who knows? That can happen, I don't know, it's fan fiction? I have some friends, this girl that, well, actually more than one, that can't stop talking about yaoi, making everyone else uncomfortable in the room. But that happens. I mean, if you want to write that, and if you want to make something about Willy Wonka erotic fiction, I'm not going to tell you that you're weird or anything. That's something that you like doing. Follow your dreams, gentlemen, ladies, however you identify yourself. Just follow your dreams. Let's go to this layer. We're going to shade this on above itself. If only to stop losing so much time. Actually, it's going to be like this kind of shading in order to keep the... Wait. What happened there? Oh, as I was saying, some weird shading is going to pop up every now and then if I keep these weird shadings above the whites that I tried to shade on their own. So yeah, he got like Disney character Mickey gloves. Can't believe I ever had an opportunity to say something like that. And not, wait. This is going to have to be an overlay. Not an overlay. How am I going to supposed to shade this? Actually, let's just do a bit of cheating. Reduce the opacity over here, and then we're going to shade it like this in one stroke. Then shade this again like this. Actually, let's just do it like this, then increase the opacity again, select this, and there we go, it got fixed, excellent. Now we go back to this, it's going to be a freaking, we still have to do it for this one too. And this one, you're going to have a color like, pow, oh freaking, no, actually no, we're going to take this, then reduce the opacity like this, and then see how this is supposed to look. Not, let's reduce it a bit more. This is better. Okay, let's increase the opacity. Now that I got selected the more or less this thing over here, over there, then this one as well. Wait, no, this is going to, actually this one should probably just be like this and just a bit darker, and more or less this is exactly doesn't work as intended, but if I keep wasting time trying to get everything on the color that it's supposed to be, this is going to not be finished on time. See? Now I'm getting the hang of this thing. How to manage my time. At the very least, I'm learning how to manage my time instead of just dabbling on the unnecessary. Am I improving? Who knows? Am I getting better at managing my time? Oh, definitely. 1 minute, 1 minute, but I don't feel overwhelmed at all. Remember the drawing of the... Actually, I should stop referencing other episodes because otherwise, well, I would really like you to watch all of my episodes, no problem. But you probably don't have the time or shouldn't... I shouldn't force you to watch them if you... Every episode should be standalone on its own. That's what makes TV a beauty, some of the episodes instead of the series. Well, okay, not just a bit more, not much time left, so let's just go to the... Wait, not like this, this... There we go, the other eye. Come on, just a bit more, there we go. What else? Is there anything missing? The teeth? Maybe we can do something with the teeth? Increase like this, then save it like that, that... Teeth. I don't like it. Let's just keep it like one singular teeth. It's the lack of details that shouldn't bother people that much, I hope. Then we got this, barely, just a bit more, one more stroke. My goodness! Oh, it always happens whenever I get too carried away with something. But hey, we got Willy Wonka's lawyer. I'm not going to develop that character a lot more, but well, it's I like the theme of it. Let's see, where is this wall thing? Did we stick to the theme correctly? Let's find out. And we got a male human. He's short, he's a lawyer, and he has this delicious theme. I'm going to add a reminder to the moski to increase the number of things in the extra world part and probably reduce the delicious thing just a bit because it's popping up all over the place. Well, anyhow, for now, that's it. Thanks for watching, and the moski is out.